Hi everybody, today I have quite possibly a very long video. Today I'm going to be showing off all 20 of my Buzz Lightyears. Or at least the full-scale ones that are the movie-accurate ones. So these aren't going to be full reviews or anything, but they will just kind of go over all of them. I don't know the names of all of them exactly, but... yeah. Okay, so starting off, we have D23 Buzz Lightyear. This is released for the D23 conventions, exclusively. He's got some different decals and stuff, color. It's more metallic and shiny than a lot of the other Disney store Buzzes. He has all the same features. Helmet, wrist communicator. Oh, well, yeah, I forgot. The wrist communicator thing is actually busted, so that's concerning. Also, the laser. Oh, yes, and he does not have working batteries in him at the moment. His joints are very loose. Very, very loose, so he's very hard to stand up. His wings still work. Other than the batteries. Karate Chop action. Hopefully. So Karate Chop action still works. But this guy is pretty cool. Next up we have Space Rescue Buzz Lightyear. This is the one that I had a review video made on. He's a really cool toy. Laser works. So that his wings also function correctly. Yeah, same scary way that all the other Thinkboy toys do. Got some nice chrome on him. And there's his back. This guy's in good condition. I like him. And next up we have my Toy Story Collection Buzz Lightyear. This is the one I've had since I was really little. Most of him still works. His arm, right, this part of his arm, so his wrist communicator actually ripped off. So his wrist communicator no longer functions correctly. Neither does his laser. His laser is very off and on, iffy, sort of. A lot of stickers and a lot of paint chips, paint chipping, whatnot. Missing the stickers here. But other than that, he is considered working.
I am Buzz Lightyear. I am Buzz Lightyear. Switching to internal air supply.
So he is nearly fully functional. Almost. Also, his green light on his wings does not function. It's only the red one that still lights up. But I still will keep him because the prices for collection Toy Story toys are getting so expensive. Like, unbelievably expensive. Next up, we have Interstellar Buzz Lightyear, who I have clearly modded to not have his helmet for some reason. Back when I didn't realize he was as rare as he is. Oh, crud. His wings also, I forgot. This guy's taking a beating, even though he is really rare. His wings suffer from a stripped wire, and now whenever you move his wing just a little bit, then they pop out immediately. He also still works.
I'm Buzz Lightyear, Space Ranger.
Yeah, so he works. He's pretty cool. I just wish I didn't take off the helmet for him. Otherwise, he'd be a bit more expensive. Next up, we have the 2015, I think, Buzz Lightyear release for the Disney Store. This is from the Disney Store, so he does have all of his phrases and whatnot. It's probably the oldest Disney Store Buzz I have, I think, at the moment. I don't have any of the early 2000s ones or whatnot. He still works.
Right now, poised at the edge of Zerg has been secretly building a weapon with the destructive capacity to annihilate an entire planet. I alone have information that reveals this weapon's only weakness.
First communicator is still connected, thankfully. Slave room, still annoying as ever. Wings, also, still work at full capacity.
Buzz Lightyear to Star Command. Come in, Star Command.
Shut up, Buzz. Helmet also still works, functions. So he still works. Also, to get it out of the way, here is my normal, or my newer Buzz, I think the 2017 model from the Disney store. He's also from the Disney store. You can tell because he has the pink head. This guy's in a lot worse condition, so his batteries no longer work. His wings from the beginning been really screwed up. Yay, malfunction. I hope he's fine other than that. I just really don't like him as much as the other one. That's my original Buzz. Again, also to get it out of the way, here is possibly the worst Buzz Lightyear to ever come out of Thinkway, or just in general. It's the Karate Chop Action one from 2019. Play garbage. You've probably all seen the video I made on it. The crappy features, and I very clearly modded him, and now he's a piece of garbage because I ripped him open. So now we have the 2001 Deluxe Electronic Talking Buzz Lightyear with the blue belt from Hasbro.
Never tangle with a space ranger, my friend.
He still works. This is one that you've probably also seen before if you follow my channel. Really yellowed body parts here and there. I tried fixing. This used to be much worse. Now it's just a decently brown. Also his wrist, this thing there. Does not have his wings, very clearly. I have not yet found one on my price range that has the wings inserted. This is Buzz that I don't really know the name of. It's a light up Buzz from, I think, 2013, 2014.
Buzz Lightyear to the rescue!
All of them, he just normally still works. Everything. He's pretty generic. Buzz, the only feature is the light up. So he still works perfectly. Now we're getting to the fun part. Now we're getting to the new crappy ones. This is the least crappy out of all. And this is the drop down Buzz. I think I like him. He's pretty cool. I like his play feature, the whole drops down. And since he's new, he works perfectly fine. Wings, the stuff. I don't have them turned on or anything. Yeah. Over here, we have these two, which are probably the worst out of the four I'm going to show you here. Toy Story, the generic Toy Story 2019 Buzz, and then the Toy Story 4 Buzz, which I completely on accident did a face swap with. This is the 30th anniversary one. The 30th anniversary one now has the Toy Story 4 one, which I think looks a little bit better.
This place needs my protection.
They
Who's
work,
in charge here?
Obviously, very clearly, they all work. 30th anniversary Buzz is probably not my favorite. My second favorite out of the new ones, the decent arm thing, decent arm molds.
I love what you've done with the place.
He has some sort of, like, weird voice. I don't like him. I don't like his voice, at least. They're very strange. And his wings, since I ripped him open, they don't really work as well as they used to, but they do open. Not as well as they used to, again, but they work, sort of. Here's a quick one. Bubble Blower Buzz from Disney World. This is the bubble blower they have currently for Disney World. You can see I've definitely used him quite a bit. I need to clean him off, sort of, but he still works, of course. Got the weird light pulsating stuff and the bubbles. I don't want to send him off because it's in my room. But the bubbles still work and whatnot, but he's just pretty simple. This is the only pose he has. Spanish Buzz. This is the Spanish Buzz from the Disney collection at JCPenney, not the actual Disney Store one. I missed out on the Disney Store one, but they still sell this guy at JCPenney, I think. Which means he has the fewer phrases. But I mean, he still works fine. Of course, he's another one. All of his features still work perfectly. Okay. Okay, we're on our last five, and these are probably the ones I have... Not him, though, at least, but these are probably the ones I have the most to talk about. This is the other one that I don't know the name of, because I got him when I was little. This was the blaster, one of the blaster buzzes that they made. There's like two, I think. This is the original one that came with the shield also, that can store in his backpack, which, oh yeah, that's really beat up there. This guy was really neat. I always really liked this guy.
Zerg's army is close. This is an intergalactic emergency.
Of course, everything's removable. And if you see on the back here, and just like in general, you see these holes and stuff. On the back there's these holes. That's because this buzz was actually made to have these two pieces fit on his jetpack. I just have them in their hands because they actually balance better when they're on his hands rather than on his back, because he gets really top-heavy and falls over like that. His wings definitely still work. I don't actually have any of the generic buzzes from the old times. So this is the only one that I have with the colored lights. Well, I guess the light-up buzz. Next up, we have the original Buzz Lightyear from 1995. This is the deluxe one, I guess. But everybody just kind of knows him as the first Buzz.
Buzz Lightyear to the rescue!
Still works. The laser you can have to push in, but the laser also works, I've discovered. I fixed it with some isopropyl alcohol a bit. But the wings, however, the same issue. They were getting so finicky that I just decided to take the wings out. There are the springs out, so the wings just open manually. And he also doesn't have a helmet. When I got him for $5 at a yard sale or whatnot, his head, I didn't realize until we got to the car, but his head is actually, it was removed, like, it was literally off, so I had to Gorilla Glue it back on, but it does not turn anymore. I don't forget if it did turn or not, I don't think so. Helmet's also missing, so, yeah. And finally, for the last of the normal Buzz Lightyears, we have the Talking Buzz Lightyear from Mattel in 2001, but I just call him the Collector's Classic one because that was how he was labeled. I don't know why, but I think this might be my favorite Buzz Lightyear that I have in my collection, at least. I think it's just because of the color scheme and it's just very, very nice. I don't know why, but the pastelish colors kind of... I like the pastelish colors that they chose for this guy. He's also super smooth. Like, really freaking smooth. I don't understand why. His helmet is like a really strange tinted blue, but I think that gives him a bit more character. And for some reason, whenever they kind of like cheap out and make the inside of his helmet green, full green, I don't know why, but I find that more appealing for some reason. It's very strange. Still works. This is the nostalgic one I was talking about. I had in my one short video. Just got a marking there. Laser still works. Everything. Wings. The wings are much less powerful than the Think White ones, but I think that's probably a good thing. I don't know. The simplicity of him is... I like the simplicity of this guy for some reason. And now we're getting to the super rare ones. This is the exclusive Toys R Us edition remote control Buzz. I consider him part of the collection just... for the heck of it. He's very beat up. His arm, actually, it does not work. You can see the wire in there. So this part, they're movable. They're robotic. But this arm just kind of sticks there. I can turn on.
I am Buzz Lightyear, Space Ranger. I come in peace.
That clicking noise is his arm. But he does normally work. I still have a remote for him so he can move around. And finally, we have the very large deluxe Buzz Lightyear walking robot or whatever from Toy Story 3. This guy is insane. He's 17 inches tall. He's freaking huge. Unfortunately, I don't think this guy, he doesn't want to work on occasion. So he'll work normally and then he'll get to a certain point where he'll start glitching out and freezing up, which is very concerning because this guy is super rare. At least I still have the remote, so if I did buy a replacement, the replacements are pretty cheap. But he does still kind of work occasionally, on occasion. I just really like it. My puppy Toby did get a huge chunk out of him, so I tried to fix it there, but I think I might need to get a new replacement for this guy, because he is kind of... I've had some times, but I think it's time for him to be retired. So there you go, that is all of them up on my shelf. Kind of did a reorganized thing here also. The only one I don't have on is Collector's Classic Buzz, just because I want to take a look at him a bit more, because I like him a lot. But yeah, you can see I have a lot, and I do have another one coming in the mail soon at some point. So that'll be exciting, and then I'll have 21 Buzz Lightyears rather than just 20. But hope you enjoyed. If you watched to the end, I pray for you. No. Thank you for watching to the end. If you did watch to the end, subscribe and like if you really want to. I don't really care. But see ya.